Okay, guys, so for math today, your teacher should have given you this sheet and this one. You can put this one off to the side. We're going to do this one together, and it's like a lesson that we would do together if I were here. So you need to have this one in front of you, and I need you to be writing along with me, because in the end, you are going to turn this in, and that's how I'll know if you did the lesson with me. Okay, so take a look at this shape. This is a net of this rectangular prism. And what we're going to do is figure out the area of each of these boxes and then add them up, because remember, that's how you find the surface area. So if we start up here, this box is 15 times 33. That's how I find the area for this one. Its matching face is this one and this one and this one, because there are four sides that are actually alike on this one. So what I want you to do right now is pause the video and actually multiply 15 times 33. So pause the video and do 15 times 33. And then when you get the answer, come back on. 15 times 33. 5 times 3 is 15, carry the 1. 45, 15, 1, 4, 495. You should have gotten 495. So the area of these rectangles is 495. And if you don't show your work, you're kind of making your life harder, because you'd have to keep doing it over and over when really you're just copying it from box to box. Now these two, which are these top two right here, the top and the bottom, those are different. Think about which numbers you're going to multiply for this top right here. Are you going to use the 15s or are you going to use the 33? And you should be saying to yourself, well, I already used the 33 and I haven't used that other 15 yet. So 15 times 15. 15 times 15. And you can pause the video and figure out what 15 times 15 is. And if you're back, you know that 15 times 15 is 225. So my next job is I have to add those together. So again, you should pause the video and you should add these. Another trick might have been to do 495 times 4 plus 225 times 2. But in the end, when you add all of these areas together, you get 2,430 centimeters squared. And that's the answer to the first one. And when you turn this in, this is the work that I need to see. Your version of it is fine. It doesn't have to look exactly like this, but I should see that you've actually done work. Let's take a look at the second one. Right away, you say, okay, this is the same thing, only it's a triangular prism, which means that three of these are going to be the same, because these are the faces here, there, and the bottom, and then these are going to be the top and the bottom, or the front and the back. Okay, so it tells me the measurements here. If I want to figure out the area of the face, the rectangular face, then that is this number times this number. So this number times this number. This number is 8, of course. So 4 times 8, which you should know, and when I look at that triangle, the only thing that makes it a little more difficult is that it's a decimal. But this is the height, and this is the base. So base times height. 3.5 times 4. And remember, you're always better off putting the decimal 3.5, the bigger number, on top. Well, not the bigger number, but the number with more digits. So 3.5 times 4. And if you need to pause the video to figure that out, go ahead. Don't forget, though, that then you need to divide it by 2. So 4 times 3.5 is 14. Half of 14 is 7. So don't forget that the formula for area here is 1/2 base times height. And the formula for area here is length times width. So now I've got 32 times 3 plus 7 times 2. And you should be figuring out your surface area. Pause the video. 32 times 3, 7 times 2, and add those together. Welcome back. And 96 plus 14 is, of course, 110 inches squared. So you should have some of this work. So either you're pausing the video and you're doing it yourself, or you're being lazy and you're just copying down what I wrote. Either way, you need to make sure you have your computation written down. This next shape is different than we have done before, and it's a square pyramid. But these are all triangles, like that, right? And it tells you that the height of those triangles is actually 12. So if I'm finding the area of these triangles, then I am 1/2 times base times height. Okay, 1/2 of 12 times 5. 12 times 5, 60 divided by 2 is 30. So these are all 30. And then the one in the middle, you have this is a side and this is a side. It's a square. And if it's a square, you might be saying, well, there's only 1/5 listed. How do I know? Well, because it's a square. So 5 times 5 is 25. So if I add 30 plus 30 plus 30 plus 30, I get 120 plus 25. Pause it if you need to. And the surface area is 145 feet squared. Okay, I would like for you to do this one by yourself. I'm not going to show you any of the work. So you're going to have to pause the video and do the work. When you unpause it, the answer will be here. But I'll know you did the work because when you turn it in, you're going to show the work. So after you unpause it, you should have found out the surface area is 948 feet squared. And you should have work for all of these so that I know that you figured out the area of all of these. Same thing for this one. You're going to need to pause the video and try to do it. Show your work for each one. And then when you're ready to unpause, this is your answer. You don't need to worry about this last one. If you want to do it, you can. That's up to you. If it's taking you a really long time, this video is right now. If you haven't paused it at all, it's almost 10 minutes, so I don't want to go more than 10 or 15 minutes. But if you want to do this one, go ahead and pause it, and when you come back, the answer will be here. The answer will be here if I write down the right answer. So 339.6 meters squared. So this one was a little bit harder because it involved a decimal. So maybe you did this one, maybe you didn't. But when I look at this, I'll be looking at 1, 2, 3, and 4. And I did the work for you for one, for the first few. These are numbered kind of funny. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I did the work for 1, 2, and 4. So now you are turning your attention to this, which should seem really easy after you've done those other more elaborate shapes. So remember, for each one, you have to find the area for each of the the faces, which in most cases is going to be doing it like this. Where you get the answer and then you multiply it by 2. Okay, so that's what you're going to do for this page. Yes, you have to do number 10. If you read it, all it is the dimensions without a box. They didn't actually draw it for you, but those are the same 3 numbers. Okay. If you have questions and Mrs. McKinley is here, you should definitely ask her. If you have questions and Mrs. McKinley isn't here, then you can always try to ask the sub, and you can also ask each other for help as long as you ask the sub if that's okay first. All right. In the end, you're going to turn both of these in. Good luck.